Welcome to Dashui Talks, a show powered by Dashui Consulting, a China-based strategic market research company founded in 2010. With Dashui Talks, you will stay up to date with all the latest business updates in China. Every day, you will learn from China-based experts who share their knowledge about the Chinese market in 2 to 5 minutes.
I'm Nicolas Koster. I am a business lawyer, French business lawyer. I have been in China for 16 years. I'm specialized in foreign direct investment. So basically, I set up companies in China, and I also sometimes liquidate them.
What are the consequences of the changes for those who have a WFOE or joint venture in China?
Okay, so for the WFOE, it's very simple. There is no consequences at the moment because the new investment law says that the WFOE will become a Chinese company, what we call the Yoshen Gongsu. This is a private limited company. And the WFOE law was based on the company law from 2006. And for the new companies, all will be based on the new company law. So that means there is no change basically for the WFOE.
How much time do I have to change the format of the company? And how will the process look like?
So the first thing he has to do, there is no emergency. The new law says you have a 5 years period. So basically from 2020 to 2025, if you want, you don't move or you move, this is your choice, okay? So the first thing you need to do is to withdraw the Article of Association and the JV contract from the Administration of Industry and Commerce, which is the Company Registry of China, to be sure that the documents you have in your file are up to date. Once you withdraw them, of course, you need to review them with your lawyer to decide if this is an advantage for you to change or to not change, and if you need to open the discussion with your Chinese partner.
Considering the change of power from the directors to the investors in joint venture, is it compulsory to change this balance of power?
It is compulsory, so that means you don't have the choice, you will have to change it.
Does it mean that the former structure, with the director deciding on the changes of the company, can block this change of balance of power to other investors and shareholders?
Until 2025, yes, they can block. After 2025, they have to follow the law, so they will not be able to block it.
Any questions? We will find an expert to answer them. Drop your questions in the comments or send us an email, dx@dashuiconsulting.com.